In this problem, we are given a figure. And in the figure, it is given that AB is parallel to DC. So let us immediately mark it out, okay? So that it helps us in solving the problem. Okay, AB is parallel to DC. And AB is equal to DC also. Okay, so this is equal to this. Now we have to prove that triangle ACD and triangle CAB, they are congruent. Now if we look at these triangles, we know that this side is equal to this side and this is a common side. So two sides are given to be equal to each other and nothing is told about these sides. Okay. So we definitely cannot use SSS criteria because the third side is not given. But something is given. We are given that AB is parallel to DC. Now, whenever something is given, it is given for a reason. It is so that we can make use of this property for proving this. Now, we know that when two lines are parallel, this will become the transversal. Okay, so AC is the transversal. Let me just extend it slightly. And these are the parallel lines. So whenever you have a pair of parallel lines and transversal, you have a set of angles which are equal. Like for example, this angle and this angle. These will be alternate interior angles and they are equal. So BAC and DCA will be congruent to each other. So we have one side, the angle and a side. Side, angle, side. So we know these are equal in both these triangles. So we cannot use SSS, but we can use SAS congruence test. Because two sides and the included angle of this triangle are equal with two sides and included angle of this triangle. So let us write this down in the proof. Remember that whenever you are given information like this, of course this is direct, but this is an indirect hint that from this we can figure out that two angles are equal. So let us begin the proof by first writing down what is given. So we'll write the first statement that in triangle ACD and triangle CAB, we have AB is equal to DC. Why is that? Because it is given. Then, we'll make a mention about the common side AC and CA. We'll say AC is equal to CA. Why? Because it is the common side. Now, let us talk about the parallel lines. Okay, these are the parallel lines. This is the transversal and these are the alternate interior angles. So, we will say that angle BAC is equal to angle DCA. And why is that? Because AB is given as parallel to CD. AC is the transversal. And we have angle BAC and angle DCA as alternate interior angles. Hence, they are equal because when a transversal cuts a pair of parallel lines, the alternate angles, interior angles are equal. Hence this. So now we can say that triangle ACD is congruent to triangle CAB. Why? From 1, 2 and 3, and which is the test? SAS, and SAS congruence test. So we have proved that these two triangles are congruent.